My name is Hilda Montenegro Fix, and this is my Olympic story. I like to introduce myself as a Costa Rican woman, a wife, a mother. My Olympic story begins with me as a whitewater raft guide in Costa Rica. I was the first and only woman in Costa Rica that got into whitewater rafting as a guide. After a few years of being a guide, I got into kayaking. And in 1991, they made the announcement that for the 92 Olympics, kayaking was going to be back as a sport, as an Olympic sport. It hadn't been there for 20 years. So that meant that any country that had a team could participate. A month before the Olympics, I was told that there was one more spot, and if I wanted to use it, I could. So unbelievable as that may sound, I said, yes, I'll go. So I had 1 month to try to learn an Olympic sport. So even though I was a kayaker, slalom in the Olympics was, first of all, in an artificial course, which I had never paddled in. And it has gates, and there's speed, and there's touches, and all this other things that I didn't know about kayaking. So it was a very steep learning curve. I was the only woman from all of Latin America competing in that sport. And I felt that it was almost a duty to just do it and do my best, and that others would come later, and people, it would get better and better, but somebody had to start. It was a very tough race. My first run just paddled down to try to make it to the finish and catch as many gates as I could on my way down. On my second run, I tried to do a little bit more of the harder moves, and that's when I flipped over, which happens, and you roll back up. But what happened was that my helmet, I hit my head on the bottom of this concrete course that we were paddling in. And so that really shook me, but I still managed to roll and come right side up, and the crowd cheered and it was exciting. But then I hit the biggest drop of the course and flipped over again. And at that point, that was as much as I could take, so I bailed. But at that time, they only counted the best of the two runs. So my first run was many, many, many minutes after the last person before me. But I did have a finishing time. So that's how I got to have an Olympic result. 1996, it was the Centennial Olympic Games. The competition was here in the United States on the Ocoee River in Tennessee. My goal in the 1996 Olympics was to make all of the gates. There were 25 gates, and I wanted to do all of them correctly. In preparation for the race, I had fallen into that humongous hydraulic that I spoke about. Well, sure enough, I had to go through the hole, and I got stopped in the hole for a moment, but I just kept my eye on the goal that I had. I am doing this, so I just was so committed and determined to do this that carried me through. And I managed to get that gate and the last gate, and then I had a second Olympics with a good finishing time. Good for me. It wasn't competitive again. You know, I wasn't last this time. I was better than a couple people. But for me, it was really all about myself doing the best I could and being able to achieve that goal that I had set. So looking back at my Olympic experience, I feel that there was so much I gained from it. Overcoming challenges, overcoming fear, having the courage to step somewhere where people maybe felt that I didn't belong because I wasn't an elite athlete. I wasn't somebody that had lots of races and lots of experience or lots of money to train or a really good boat. Like it really, there were many things I had to overcome. My fear of the water, my fear of the course, know how to discern and follow your heart, follow your spirit, and don't hesitate. Even when you think that something seems impossible or difficult, I mean, I would tell people later, who gets invited to the Olympics? I did. I was actually invited the first time. The second time I had to compete and earn a spot, and it was totally against the odds. Anybody would have bet against it, but I thought I could, and then I did. And I think that we all can. I think we all have that strength in ourselves.